Give your shiny new splitboard a workout this weekend at the legendary Imperial Challenge. Phil Lindemann, Krystal, 93 News. First, closing day at Breckenridge is less than a week away, but terrain is already limited. Starting yesterday, peaks 6, 7, and 10 are closed for the season, while Lower Silverthorne and Sawmill are the only open trails on peak 9. That leaves lifts on peak 8, but there are plenty, including T-Bar, 6 Chair, Imperial Chair, and the Super Connect. 10 Mile Station is closed for the year, but the Maggie and Sevens will be open through Sunday. Officials say the resort will not reopen terrain, even if Breck gets 2 feet of fresh. Summit County is home to more than 1,200 military veterans, but local service officer Dwayne Daly says only a fraction are getting the support they earned.
It's estimated that about 50 to 60% of eligible veterans, especially on the western slope, aren't even registered. So they're totally unaware of the benefits that they have earned.
Summit County is hosting a Veterans Resource Fair tomorrow, Wednesday, to put local veterans in touch with officials from state and federal programs, including workforce centers, the VA hospital, and vet-only home loan services.
Getting enrolled in the system is often frustrating, not understanding how to navigate, but once you get in, most veterans are very happy with the services they get and the providers and the doctors and nurses that they deal with.
The Veterans Resource Fair is tomorrow from noon to 3 p.m. at the Summit County Community and Senior Center. All veterans who attend get a free lunch. After 27 years, there's finally a division just for snowboarders at the legendary Imperial Challenge. The annual race from Airport Road to the summit of Peak 8 and back returns this Saturday, and race director Jeff Westcott announced 2 new divisions, one for splitboarders and one for solid snowboards. The Imperial Challenge is an unusual triathlon, and this year, there's something a little different. Everyone bikes to the base of Peak 7, not Peak 8, then skins to the Peak 8 summit and skis or snowboards back to the base for a total of 3,500 vertical feet. Longtime local Mike Day convinced Westy to add the divisions. Day says he finished the challenge for the first time ever a few years ago on a splitboard and was one of only 4 or 5 snowboarders. He'll be back this year and hopes new divisions bring more boarders to an event he calls classic. Cost is $55 for all divisions. Sign up and learn more at mavsports.com. In sports, the Rockies play the Pirates tonight. First pitch is 5:05. The Avalanche play Game 4 of their playoff series against the Predators tomorrow. Nashville leads 2-1. And in local sports, all Summit High sports teams are off this week for spring break. Play resumes next Tuesday. Phil Lindemann, Krystal, 93 News.